here with 130 prospect Thomas Herrera. Herrera, you're fighting this Friday. How do you feel about your upcoming fight?
I feel great, man. I'm excited. I fought for Golden Boy in a minute, so you know it's about that time again. I gotta get that exposure.
Let's talk about some of the big fights coming up. Mayweather versus Berto next week. How do you see it playing out?
It's gonna be a good fight. Berto's a strong opponent. Mayweather is the champ. He's faster. He's smarter. I think he's got the win by unanimous decision.
Wow, unanimous decision. That's a good prediction right there. Miguel Cotto versus Saul Canelo Alvarez. Puerto Rico versus Mexico. It doesn't get any better, man. Youth versus experience.
Oh, man. That'll probably be fight of the year, man. That's really going to be a good, entertaining fight. A lot of action. But both fighters are very strong. So, like you said, it's youth versus experience. That's up in the air for me. Yeah.
Triple G versus Lemieux. Cotto versus Canelo is set to fight the winner of Triple G versus Lemieux. How do you see that fight playing out?
I don't know. I'll probably have to go with Triple G.
Triple G, but it looks like he's finally facing a guy that hits as hard as he does. You think that's fair to say? That Golovkin, Lemieux is just as big a puncher as Golovkin?
Right. I'm just going to go with Golovkin because I've seen him fight more. I know him a little better. So I just have to say Golovkin.
Who is the top fighter right now at the moment in boxing?
What weight?
In general, who pound for pound? Is it Mayweather? Is it safe to say Mayweather?
As of right now, yes, Mayweather. But, once he retires, once he, hangs those gloves up, then that's when the new era comes. That's when Keith Thurman comes, Triple G, Danny Garcia. You got this whole generation of boxers evolving. So
there's a lot of fans out there criticizing him, choosing Berto. Do you think there's a better opponent out there he could face at the moment?
I think so. He should have chose, one of these upcoming, superstars like, Thurman or... Garcia, one of these young undefeated guys, because I know they're undefeated, so it's going to hurt them, to get that loss in their record. And, of course, it'll make
bigger. When Mayweather's gone, who do you think has the potential to take over the pay-per-view slot?
Okay, once Mayweather's gone, I would have to say they're Canelo, Triple G, Garcia, Thurman, same fighters.
Do you think Canelo has improved since his loss to Mayweather, or is he still the same fighter?
Every fighter evolves after a loss. We learn from our mistakes. So I'm sure he's learned. Yeah, he's made some changes in his...
Who are some of the fighters that you grew up watching that pushed you into boxing?
I'd have to say Chavez, Tyson and Camacho.
For the fans that don't know you, how would you describe your style and your boxing ability?
I'm a typical Mexican fighter. I bring the pressure. I put the pressure on. I come forward. But also, I like to box. So I'm a little bit of both. I'm a boxer and I'm a brawler. Whatever needs to be done gets the work done.
The Mexican community does. We're the ones that criticize Mayweather the most.
Right.
Why is that, man? Why don't we always give him his complete credit? We always come up with maybe a reason to discredit him.
As the Mexican fans, they just want to see a war. They want to see blood.
Yeah.
If they don't see blood, they see someone running around. To them, that's not boxing. But that's just the Mexican crowd in general. But I understand. It's understandable. Yeah. They don't want to see a boring fight. But hey, it's what makes the wins and makes the money and what makes him today. So you gotta give him respect.
How'd you see Mario Santa Cruz? How'd you see that fight?
That was a good fight. That's what the fans wanted to see. It was action-packed. It was exciting. Santa Cruz had that, reach advantage. So, Matis had to get in there. And, he pressured him. He smothered him. He did what he had to do.
Yeah.
But if he would have, just used that jab a little bit more and just...
You think the cards were okay? A lot of people complain about the 114-114.
Yeah,
how'd you see that?
I think it should have been, a lot closer. That's... That's just boxing for you, it's business, and unfortunately, sometimes it's not fair, but that's how it works.
A few people have gone as far as to say that a rematch is necessary. What do you think?
I would have to say a rematch. Because now Matis knows he has a better idea of what kind of fight he needs to put out there. So he'll just go back to the drawing board, make some fixes, mistakes, or we could think he could do better. And a rematch, definitely. I would see a rematch happening.
Lucas Matisse versus Victor Postoa, StubHub Center. You already know the StubHub Center. It always goes down. How do you see that fight playing out?
I'd have to go with Lucas Matisse because, you know, I'm a Matisse fan. He's just a warrior, man. He comes to fight.